Hello there, HPI Guys Model Workshop, back with another kit review for you. This is Lindbergh's USS Manchester light cruiser in 1/600th scale. This is what they call box scale. They scaled the ships back then to fit inside a certain box for the hobby shop shelf instead of being one of the more popular scales that we see nowadays, which is like 1/700th, 1/350th. These were scaled back then. This kit's been reproduced for many, many decades. And Lindbergh is carrying on the ships of this style. I've also reviewed the Scharnhorst by Lindbergh in this sort of off scale, in this box scale, and it seemed to be a pretty nice kit. This Manchester I got for about $8 online on clearance. It seems like a nice kit, so let's take a look inside the box and see everything you're going to get. Now, this is not a parts heavy kit, so bear with me here. Right there, these two little things, we don't need to get those up closely. That is the stand. And where you're going to use that is, this is the hull. And it's 12 inches long. And you will just place the hull in those little holes underneath. See, there's these little holes under here. And you'll see there's other holes underneath here as well. And we'll get to those in a second. But when you're building it, you can just stick the stand in those holes like so. And it'll sit like that on your display stand when you're done. It's not a very fancy stand, but it does exactly what it should do. And it works well, and it fits well. Now, there's some other holes. This is, of course, the hull. It's all one piece. And if we focus on it, you can see some of the steel plating. Very faint lines, but in this scale, they shouldn't be really pronounced anyways. And if you follow one of the ones towards the bottom, if you wanted to make this a waterline kit, you could cut that right off at exactly that line and place it as if the ship was in the water. Now, on the bottom of the hull, you're going to see these holes here. These are for mounting your propellers and your propeller shafts. These two holes here, I had no idea what they were for because they're not mentioned in the manual. But I figured it out, so I'll let you guys in on that when we get to that point. Now, the upper deck, which is a two-piece deck, mounts right like so. It fits pretty good. It fits flush once it's all in place. There are numerous locating pins on the deck and on the hull to make sure you get it lined up correctly. When it's all together, it does look nice on there. There's only one issue, is that, you know, it's got all these pins and these locating marks. So you can make sure that it fits in right and you can glue it in tightly. The only thing is, once you get the deck glued on, you'll have to deal with some of these holes. See that right by my finger, casting a shadow? When they injected it, the holes kind of came through. Now, once you fill that with styrene glue, those are going to fill in completely. Those are going to kind of melt. Let's get up to another one here. See that one in the front there, right underneath my thumb? They're going to kind of melt, and they're going to fill those in. And then all you have to do is just take a little bit of putty and just push it in there. Anything that's left, sand it smooth, sand all these tree marks off where they ripped it out of the tree when they made it in the factory, and you'll be fine. But that is a detractor on the kit, but it's something that even a beginning modeler could do. It's very good practice to practice filling in those little tiny defects like that. So, and remember, the cost of this kit was $8. And it's older than most of the people that are watching this video. So there it goes together like that. You can see it makes for a nice presentation. The other parts in the kit aren't many. You get some flags, and you get a very small set of decals. You can see the decals right there. All you need for that ship, really. If you wanted to go aftermarket and put some waterline or water depth decals on the bow, that's up to you. Here's a small parts tree. And what I was trying to figure out was what the heck this was. Because I don't remember that being a part of any battleship, this giant bulb thing. And then I thought back to what I showed you earlier, which was these two holes. And it's a one-piece hull, like a bathtub hull. And I'm thinking, you know, I bet when this was produced, and, you know, kids were building these. And all you have to do is put a little bit of epoxy or a couple BBs inside there. Glue these two together and glue it to the bottom of the hull, and you could build a battleship that you could take into the bathtub. You can have your cruiser out there. You can have some other ships out there. And I think that's exactly what it's for. It's not mentioned in the manual whatsoever, but that's what I think it's for. And then I've got some other smaller parts here. Those would go inside to reinforce the hull. Those tabs will go right in there and there. That just keeps it from getting squidgy. So that's what I think those are. If you don't think that's what that is, because that assembles just like so, if you don't think that that's a bulb that's supposed to have a weight as a keel, so that when you put this in the sink or in the bathtub or take it to the pond, that it doesn't tip over, you let me know. But I think that's exactly what that's for, even though it's not mentioned whatsoever. Now there's one set of plastic tree left, and that's got all the deck detail. That's going to have, as we can see, the superstructure, the guns, levels to the superstructure, more of the main guns, cranes, and float planes. So we'll take a close look. You can see the detail's pretty sparse. The railings are thick. But again, it's an inexpensive model kit. It's what I call close enough scale. There's a little bit of flash on it, but not much. Anybody could build this in a weekend. Slap some paint on it, you have a respectable enough battleship. No, this will not compete with the Tamiyas, the Zvezdas, the Hasegawas, the Italeri, the Dragon ships. No, not even close. Don't even try to compare them. If you try to compare them, you're a fool. Because these kits are older. They've been reproduced many times, and they're more what I call fun scale. If you built this up and painted it and weathered it nicely and just spent a weekend on it, you would have a very nice representation of a model ship in your collection, and only the purists would be able to look at it and go, well, this isn't right and this doesn't look perfect. Anybody else would say, hey, that's a cool battleship. And that's your small parts trees. There's your airplanes, your float planes. Good amount of flash on those. You just have to sand right off. Snip it off first, then sand it off. And your little propellers. And the cranes. And the masts. And some of the gun housings. Part of your superstructure, smokestack. Or the guns with the flash. And superstructure railings and decks. All right there. That's about it. I can show you the manual. I didn't think it was extremely important to go over, but I do want to be thorough. All it is just the one sheet on both sides. You can see it's very simple. They show the holes for those bulbs on the bottom, but they don't actually show you the bulb. I'm thinking, well, when the kit was made, that was part of the stuff on there, and it was just so you could play with it. But you can see they have you assemble the superstructure, the island, and all the different decks, and then they tell you that the thread's not included, but you could rig it up. And a little bit of rigging would actually make it look kind of nice, a little more professional. So for $8, it's worth it. I don't think it's worth a whole lot more than that out on the market. If you're going to spend more money, buy one of the nicer ships. But for good enough scale, for something fun to build on a weekend, I definitely think this was worth it. This was my review of Lindbergh's USS Manchester Light Cruiser. Thanks for watching HPI Guys Model Workshop.